Brought to you by
Eaton Detroit Spring. Proudly made in the USA.
Classic car or muscle car, we want to show you how to restore your automobile and save yourself some money in the process. Sometimes we consult the pros, sometimes we mess up. But just remember, it's never a problem, it's always a project.
This week on Auto Restomod, Vinny, Cam, and Jeff tackle a laid-back and low-down sitting solution for tall critters like Cam.
I can't touch the floors.
Honey, what are you doing out there?
Waiting on the next Super Blowout 3-Day Only Mega Sale.
You don't need a sale. You need NPD.
NPD's everyday prices are competitive with most sales, and orders arrive fast from our four strategically located superstores. National Parts Depot has quality parts for Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, GTO, Firebird, Ford, and Chevy truck. For your free catalog, go online or call toll-free.
Working beats waiting.
Well, guess what?
All right, a seat pan.
The seat pan is here.
Cool, so we can get it that much closer to being drivable again.
Yeah, we don't have the driver side.
This
is the right-hand side. This is the only one they've got right now.
It's a sample.
And it's, we literally have the second set of these ever made.
Wow, that's
cool. So it's kind of good, but it's not gonna be real true layout of exactly how these things are going to fit, because I got a few more tweaks to make on them, but they wanted to go ahead and get these to us because basically I whined and complained about having our seats sitting on the floor, and then we get the
you squeaky wheeled them.
Yeah, I did.
So I got your back.
And we get the right side, but he said the left is on the way. So I should be able to get the left in here pretty quick and throw that thing in, but I just want to show guys some tips and tricks this week on how to put this stuff in.
Cool.
So let's get busted.
Cool.
Yeah, that's not happening.
Need longer seat rails, don't you?
Need a lot of everything.
You can see Cam's having a little bit of a problem getting into the car. That seat is sitting literally on the floor. He's got plenty of headroom now, but the leg room is a problem. Now go ahead and pile on out of there, Cam. As we all know, Cam is a big dude. And being a big dude, these cars are sometimes kind of problematic. Even Gina has a problem because Gina is 6'4" tall, so she has a lack of leg room and she wants a little more headroom in the car. So we're going to be doing something about that today, talking about extended seat rails and also talking about dropped floor pans. Let's get busy.
Yay.
Okay, so loving Mustangs, being big and tall. Kind of a problem, especially if you really like the fastbacks, because the fastbacks are a little low on headroom compared to the hard tops, and it can create kind of an issue. Guys like Cam, who are really big, as we've said, don't fit in those cars quite so well. And part of the problem is the seat pans. Now, the seat pans in the 65 on up Mustangs are fairly tall. The cars were actually designed for guys that are about 5'8"-ish. If you were a little taller, a little shorter, that was okay. But when you start getting into some of the heights that we are now, and I'm about 6 foot, Vince is 6 foot, Gina's 6'5", Cam's around 6'4", 6'5", the Mustang isn't really, quote unquote, a good fit. Now the pan that I have over here on my left is actually the new pan for their Cougar line. Now this pan that we have here will also fit in a Mustang, and it will drop the seat about an inch. You might say that an inch doesn't make that much difference in seating, but honestly, for headroom, it really does. And another thing that you can do, also from the guys at National Parts Depot, are these seat extenders. Now, these will give you about 2 inches of additional depth to your seat. So in other words, you can pull the seat even further back. So you guys that are taller won't feel like you're sitting around like a monkey inside of a Mustang when you're driving the car. These will help give you a little bit more leg room as well. So you have more leg room, you have more height for your seat, and you don't have to use these and do some of the things that needed to be done to make these work, and I'm going to talk about that right now. Okay, now I'm going to put this in here and talk about some of the things that you can do even with a standard seat pan. Now there is a way to go in and do what I call a section cut out of the pan, and that's basically taking about, well, actually just splitting the pan all the way across front and rear, knocking it loose on both the inside over here and the tunnel side over there, and actually modifying it and dropping it down inside these pieces that you left that you cut from the bottom here. The only thing about that is it's kind of a sloppy process. You have to be really careful about your positioning of the pan when you do that. In my opinion, if I'm doing a modified car, I'm actually going to go ahead and do the 1-inch drop pans anyway. And the cool thing is if you're doing an interior upgrade on an existing car, you can go in and cover up the interior of the car and actually weld in a set of these other pans. You can take the pans that are in there out of the car and weld in these new ones, and you're not going to affect your outside paint. You're not going to affect anything except some spots on the underside of the car on the painted undercarriage. And then if you want, you can go back in and repair that, sand it down, and it'll look like new after you've put these in, because basically you're going to do a spot type weld in these. Now, some guys have written in and asked, can I just pull these seat pans out of the car? No, because this is a frame supporting member of the car. These pans actually do a dual function. They are here to add support to a cross brace across the chassis. The tunnel is part of that, as is the seat pan on both sides. So you want to make sure you weld these things in nice and solid whenever you're doing this so that you get a good bracing in here. Now, Vinny's going to talk to you about some of the things that you can run into whenever you're doing these kind of modifications, because once you start doing modifications, guess what? Things inside the car start to change, and some of them can be kind of a pain to deal with.
So what we have here is a dry fit of the standard height pan with the carpet set. And the problem you're going to run into with the lower pan is the carpet sets. The carpet sets for the 65 to 68 Mustangs are designed to fit with this pan. So if you try to use the lower pan with the standard carpet set, it's not going to fit really well. There is a solution though, real easy. Just go to a 69 carpet set and it'll fit and you'll be good to go.
Okay, I want to talk to you about a couple of little detail items with what we've got going on with this particular car. Now, we had them put the pans in here at Mustang Central, and I want them to do that because they do a lot nicer job than I could ever do. But the nice thing that Alan did for me when he did that is, A, he went in and he used, I don't think you can see it maybe, but he used screws to put the floor pan in on the outside, and then he also left the lip for the old seat pan in here so that we have a location for where the seat pan is supposed to sit. Had he taken this out, it would have been a lot harder for me to figure out where this needs to be. So, if you're gonna be doing this, you're putting your seat pans in and you're doing other things, I would recommend leaving that lip in there whenever you're doing it, just so that you've got a reference point. You'll wanna knock that thing out if you're putting a stock seat pan in, but if you're putting the other pan in and you wanna be a cheeky monkey, you could actually just grind the lip down and leave the sucker there, because it actually sits so far down, it's underneath that. So, the reason he left the screws in the sides over here is so that we can adjust the floor up and down a little bit so that we can make the floor meet up to the bottom of the pan. I'm going to show you that in just a second, how to get the floor pan neatened up and get the floor matching the pan, because you want the pan to sit level so that your seats aren't all cockeyed in the car. We'll get stuff to do that. Okay, when you're doing the seat pans, you want to make sure that you don't put the seat pans to the floor first. What you really want to do is you want to establish that your pans are straight this way, sitting in the car, so they're not sitting crooked toward the back. Then you also want to make sure that your pans are also level. You don't want the pan sitting in a downhill slide to one side or the other. Now, the best way to establish whether your pans are level is to actually take a level somewhere off of the car and work toward that with this. I've already gone in and put a bolt in over here in the back, and I've set it up so that it's 1 inch from the bottom of the other pan. You can see that on here with the ruler. We're right at an inch. That's close enough for my book. Like I said, these cars are kind of ish cars, so you'll be okay doing what we've done here. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to establish my level on the car by going in and putting a level up here. Okay, now I've got my level in here, and I can show you that the car is sitting a little bit over toward the driver's side. So I want to make sure that my pan kind of mimics that. It's okay as long as it's inside those black marks and your bubble isn't disappearing somewhere on the pan, you should be fine. Now, what I'll do next is I'm going to set this up on top of here, and I can see that basically the front edge of this pan, if you look at the bubble level here, is sitting in exactly the same place as it was when it was up inside the glove box, telling me that As far as its relationship to the dash panel is concerned, our pan right now is sitting level. The one thing I will say that it is not sitting straight in the car. It's actually sitting this way pretty dramatically. The inside of the pan at the tunnel is in this way. What I finally came up with is this. I use a carpenter's L, and my carpenter's L I set up here in the, just let it sit where it's in resting in the break point between the pan and the tow board, and I took and marked a line across the floor pan, and I pulled my L back, and across the center line of the two holes, I ran a line across here. Now the reason I did that is this, is there's not really any good flat straight place in here to take a measure off of without putting a line on the floor and on the pan somewhere. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull a measure on it. We're at 20 3/4 here and 20 3/4 there. So now I know that my seat pan is even across the holes. Now the reason I do the holes is this. You could possibly go and measure across the back here where this flange is, but I've seen these flanges actually come in a little crooked. It could have taken some damage that we can't really see that has pushed this back break over in a little bit. Now I've already got one screw in here. Now that I know I am sitting where I need to sit, I'm going to put a tap screw right here instead of putting it up in here, because I find a lot of times if you put them up into the flange here, that the actual flange will walk up and away from you and it'll scoot that pan back. If you put it in that front flange there, in through the floor, which you're gonna need to do some of that anyway, it's not going to affect anything on your lift you may need to do out here, and it'll solidify this pan in the position it needs to be in. So I'm gonna put mine right there. Okay, now on our seat pan, because we are sitting on this section of the floor here, we're good to go. Our level is really decent now. It's about the middle. We could be off a little bit either way. I don't think your behind is gonna feel that when you sit in the seat. The problem we do have, and this is why Alan left the outer rail undone, is now if I take and run my finger along here, my finger can get up underneath the pan pretty deep at this end right here. So I'm kind of in a place where I need to go in and jack up this outside pan a little bit. That's why Alan didn't go in and put any welds on the outside of this rail so that we could jack this outside edge of the pan up if we so needed to, and we do on this car. So we're gonna jack this up just a little bit. And what I've done is I've got a jack up underneath here with a piece of wood to spread the load. So we got the jack, and I'm gonna jack that up and see if I can get this pan to come up into position a little bit better. Yeah, the pan is now about where it needs to be sitting, and I'll have to go in and put some more self-tapping screws in here to hold it in place. But we look pretty good across the board on that. Now that pan's where it needs to be, I'm gonna take this edge and bump it back and down just a little bit and start welding this in. But while I'm working on this, Vinny's gonna talk to you about the seat extenders we're putting on the seats in this car.
We had talked about the seat extenders earlier, and here they are. Very easy to install. They just slide right on top of the seat studs, and you've actually got two pegs on either side. You've got holes right in the new seat extenders that'll go right over the pegs, and then you just bolt them down. Now when you do a final install on these, you'll want to go ahead and use Loctite on these nuts. So right now we're just doing like a fit test, and in addition to the Loctite on final, once you have the nuts snug down good, you're gonna go ahead and you're gonna trim that bolt right to the, so that it's flush with the nut. One other thing we did, we went ahead and ran a die down the old studs just to make it a little easier to get the new nuts on them. They get a little rusted up and corroded, so it just makes your installation a lot easier. And just like that, I've got an extra 2 inches.
Now hack the old ones off.
Surely we have something better than that.
All right, now what I've done is I've gone in and used some Rust-Oleum semi-gloss black on this to keep it from rusting out. Now this, if you put the plugs in the bottom of the pan, this shouldn't be an issue of rust. And by the time this thing would rust through, you're probably not gonna be here anymore. So shouldn't be a bad problem. But another thing I did is you can see here on the tunnel where I've gone in and ground the spots where my holes are in the actual pan itself. And I use this pin here, this auto rider, to get that done. That way I don't grind the entire panel where it's already got the primer on it and keep it from having, again, rust problems. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and set this thing and screw it to the floor and then start doing some welding on it, and we'll go on from there. So what we want to do is we want to show you how that seat sets in there. Now this is actually sitting in really nice now. I mean, it basically falls into position. So I'm pretty happy with it at this point. But I'm going to go ahead and screw those in there just so I've got a good tight fit to the floor. And that's why I wanted to put these back in, so I can get right back in correct position to put this thing in the floor. Okay, now I'm going to grab my MIG welder, come in here and start laying this pan in and getting it finalized so I can put the seat in here and show you how much lower everything sits and how much more leg room you have in the front. We don't have a way to do a test, but I can tell you right now, you're going to get an inch of headroom and 2 inches of leg room with the extenders and the seat pan in here. So, go and get my MIG and get started on this. Okay, now what I'm going to do here is I've got my MIG welder set up and ready to go. I'm going to cross pattern this like I do everything else when I'm welding. Again, I'm not going to show you guys the welding part of this because I basically really stink at welding. But I'm going to go ahead and weld this thing in to a degree. And we're also going to go in and finalize the outside lip of the floor pan that Alan had just put in with zip screws. And then we will put the seat in here to show you how much lower it sits and how much more seat track room you have on these seats. But I'm going to go ahead and do one thing before that. I'm going to go back in and check my measures just to make sure before I final weld this thing in. Because the last thing you want to do before you weld, make sure that your measures are good, because if they're not, you may end up with a crooked seat pan even so. Okay, we are good to go. So, I'm going to start welding, put the seat in, and we'll close this bad boy out. Well, Vinny, I can't touch the toe board with my toes.
That's a good thing.
For you and Gina, yeah. I kind of feel like I'm sitting really low. I'm not used to this position in a 65. I'm used to kind of being up a little bit higher and my arm being a little less up in the air. But I have to tell you that with a new set of seat buns on these seats, that'll lift you up a little bit. It'll feel a little more normal to you. But man, I'm telling you what, you are not going to get anybody in that back seat the way it is unless it's like Tattoo or somebody that doesn't have any knees.
That's okay. We don't use the back seat.
I was going to say, you guys don't have kids or anything, so it's not really that big an issue.
That's because we don't use the back seat.
Well, never mind. I'm not going to go there. This this was actually a pretty nice little deal. I like this. Like we said, use 69 carpet with it, and you should be good to go. All right, next week, folks, we'll be coming back with a few fast breaks. We got a couple that we want to throw up, some things on vent windows and stuff like that that we'll throw out there for you, because for us, next weekend is Thanksgiving Day weekend, and I'm not asking anybody to work on a national holiday. So do us a favor and come back and watch us next time on Auto Resto Mod. Have a great week, folks.
I can't touch the floors.
That's fun.
Mic check.